Welcome back to Break. You are still watching Solid Talk, and I'm your girl, Savaria Hughes. Hey, hey. Before we went for the commercial break, we were still engaging with our guests, getting to know them and what they be doing in their day-to-day life. But for now, I want to know, and for those of you out there, what's your go-to type of holiday? Ngagwe, you've never left the country. You can still also tell us. Well, like, if you want to go to Fort Porto, like, what's your go-to type of holiday? Where would you want to visit? Like, the places, tropical, or for you, you would want to go in some place and it's very cold. I don't know. But I'm going to start with Stuart. Yeah, today, Kudina, today we have, we have to talk about this thing. So, Stuart, like, what's your go-to type of holiday? What is that one place you would want to visit and you would feel like you are at home?
Tropical is, it is. I mean, somewhere where it's quiet, somewhere where, you know, it's conducive, beautiful. Because, you know, with the nature of work I do, it's usually in the night, noise and whatnot. So I would love to be somewhere where it's very quiet, yeah, but peaceful at the same time. But also, you know, fun, like that.
Speaking of nice life, Stuart, I have here like a question. So, being a DJ, and you have seen a lot of beautiful girls that I know. Very many of them, I'm very sure, have hit on you, even the rich mummies. So, like you as a person, you are Stuart, you are Sleek.
Why are you looking so serious on that now, Stuart?
Because I'm preparing the answers.
He's looking for the answer in the head. He's looking for a lie.
He knows he's being watched at home. He's in trouble. Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
So, yeah. What comes in your mind when these girls throw themselves on you? Do you give them the opportunity, or you respect yourself, you as yourself?
I think it goes down to being professional. I mean, I'm here to serve the crowd, to serve the people. I try and be exactly who I need to be, professional. Yeah, I mean, it's work time. That's what I found first. Yeah, but I'm open to being, to making friends. And basically, that's my, my limit.
Okay. We shall leave it there. Abagala or Kumanya more. You can feel free to go down to Slick's DM, but I'm very sure you'll be rejected. Just don't try it. But you can feel free to go and follow him on his Instagram. Just follow.
If I can ask, how many female friends, if you can give us a rough number, do you even know how many you have?
Honestly, I need to say thank you first of all. To the females, they are my biggest fans.
Yes.
They are my biggest fans.
That is very true.
I'm just cracking you up.
The reason why when I was introducing him, I called him Kampala, like you, the Ugandan boy, because he was considered that. He is still considered that. He's among.
I've heard his name, because
you speak for yourself. But speaking of holidays, what you're from the UK and you have seen a lot of places. I'm very sure. So, what is that favorite place you've visited and it left something in your heart?
Honestly, that's why I'm still broke, because I live, I work to travel. I love to travel the world. I just work and travel, and I will die poor traveling.
Wow, I think we have the same thing. Just the tuna, yeah. For the tuna, yeah.
I just love traveling, and when I travel, I just want to go in the local people. I want to know the local people. I want to eat the food. I want to know the culture. Always, every time I've traveled.
So you're this type of tourist, yeah. Whereby if you go, yeah, to a type of country, yeah, you do not spend money, yeah, in a 5-class hotel, blah, 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 in restaurant. You go for the...
No,
the
I love top hotels. I love views. I love to be in a good environment. But then I get out of the hotel and then I go in villages and I try to see the local people. I want to know the food, the local food, what type of good food they eat. I love music. I want to see their local music. I want to see their culture. I get to know people. I get out of the hotels and I go to the local places. And just recently, where I've just been in Positano. in Italy, and it's beautiful. It's one of it's beautiful. I want to reassure you, like, you are so lucky that you are in Africa, and even if you say that you are not traveling, but Uganda alone,
yeah,
if you can go around in Uganda alone, we you don't I would say you would not want to go
anyway,
in other parts
they
of the
Uganda
world.
Uganda is a part of Africa, and I really love Uganda for one thing. Its nightlife is amazing.
It's one of the most beautiful.
It is beautiful. I need to add, it is beautiful. If you ever travel out there, my experience, I travel out, but then I'd be missing home like that. So crazy.
Really?
Like that. So that's how beautiful it is. Yeah.
Yeah. There is. Have you been to this place in Fort Potro? It is. There is a crater. It's called. It's in the middle of the forest. I've forgotten the place, but
I would have contributed.
Every time I come here, I have definitely. I'm so sorry that I forgot the place. When I remember it, I will say it on the camera.
Okay. Omukuru, akavili bakasaze. Oh, we have a good thing. We have a good thing. Massage. Speed. So when you're on vacation with maybe say you, maybe your family, have you traveled before?
Oh yeah. Let's plan on going on a vacation together. No, that's what he wants anyway. That's what he should want.
Yeah, against the land cow.
Okay,
what's your go-to type of like holiday? Like, what do you want to do? Would you want to go with your family, with your boys, or do you want to go you or one? You know, maybe they are there also. Often I go often here.
Neda, Kubango Red and Nina. Let's start there.
I'm going to Muli Reya. Four of my Abela now, but when he has somebody else, or even four of them.
No, we need to talk. But anyways, as a publicist, half the time I'm drilled in work. So I also like it quiet, you know.
Yeah.
I go with someone, get to know each other better, and also explore, see how other environments work. So I like it quiet. But this time, njagalera mfune n'obudde n'abaana bange ne family, the many nieces and nephews, twogeremu, you know, abaana kati bakuze, twogeremu health, twogeremu. So that's my kind of vacation, a bit chilled and you know, more about exploration.
What's the favorite place you have ever visited, like the name of the place you have ever visited and it left something on your heart and you're like, I want to go back there?
Okay, no puns intended. Mumbai, India.
Wow, we are being represented. India, outside. I've also never been there, but you know what's funny? Every time people see me and they be like, "Ah, you have Indian? Have you been to India before?" I be like, "Yeah, I was. I went there when I was a kid. I don't remember."
And you can go there. Trust me. Let's plan. I'm ready.
No, I am going.
Let me know when you're ready.
It's not like I'm never gonna leave the country. I actually am.
Mm.
But being Munai Mwakatani,
no, let's do this.
You have to be around.
So Varia, let's do this. Let's do this. We're here. You're a TV hostess. She's an artist.
I'm actually also a model and an actress. But anyway, it's not about me today.
Mal talented as you are.
Beautiful. You should talk about that.
Thank you.
You should talk about that.
But my modeling career though.
There is an award, Malt award winning DJ. That's already an event right there.
Hey.
You understand? So let's find
but
a place.
Events, man. Events,
no, just be positive, girl. Let's just do this. What do you think?
No, I think that she's so beautiful. I saw it and I said to myself, oh my gosh, she's a model. And I wasn't shocked to see her here presenting.
Doing
the presentation. I mean, the world is the limit.
You
can go wherever you are. Yeah, you can go. The sky is the limit.
Okay, Slick, you say you travel a lot and you love those peaceful areas since you're always in the nightlife. What's your favorite place you've been to, like the name of the place you've been to? Nogambaha. This one, I have to come back sometime.
I mean, I've traveled not so much, like everywhere, but you know, probably enough. But there's one place I've not been to. And I feel like I need to...
To go there?
Yeah.
Where is that? Which is that?
Brazil.
Really?
Yeah.
I kind of have a feeling that because you're a DJ, like you wherever you travel, you spend the whole night in the clubs, and in the morning you're sleeping. So you get out of the place without seeing the places, like you're tired
my
during the day.
My actual reason to why I need to travel to Brazil is, first of all, when I see it on TV, or maybe when I see on the internet, I feel like those guys party like how we do.
Yeah,
you know, they have the beach life and whatnot, so it's beautiful, and that's my kind of vibe. So I feel like I'm missing out on that, that's one of my goal, the places I want to visit before.
I think one of the advantages we've got these days is that because of the social network and the internet, the world has become one place. So you can really. I mean, Europe used it to just show only the slums in Africa and flies. But now, like where I come from, all my friends are like, please take us to Uganda, because they see all these beautiful safaris, all these beautiful five-star hotels, all the beautiful buildings. And they are like, they really get upset that I'm not bringing them over. But we don't have to talk so much about where we come from. I tell them, like, look, we are queens and kings where we live. Space, everything is amazing. And they see now we've got expatriates coming over. Yeah. And I think that's the beautiful thing that internet is talking for us. Okay. We don't have to tell who we are.
All right, as we still continue the conversation, allow me to first go make some money. My boss has ordered us to make some money. This is First Go for a short commercial break. You are still watching Selling Talk.